Hello everyone, I'm Tim Tope Ajibola, popular in our T-Square. We have to take on topics. The first one is what? Set. What's a set? Set is a collection of objects, items that is well defined. Again, collection of items or objects that is well defined. Or collection of items that share the same character. That is what God is set. E.g., mathematical sets is an example of a set. So that is just the definition of a set. Now, the terms we use in set, you have to understand it. The first one is what is universal set. Now, what's the universal set? The symbol, this symbol or. So is that you put this as the symbol of this? That is what God. But what is universal set? This is a word that contains all sets under consideration or supervision. Again, this is the one that contains all sets under consideration or supervision. That's what we call universal sets. Then the second one is what? Union of sets. What is union of sets? This is a combination between two sets. Combination between two sets. Without repetition. Take for instance, if set A to B, C, and set B to B, C, D, E, then A union B will be what now? Combination of the two sets now. A, B. Can you see that C? You have twice. So I'll just write one of them. Then D, E. So this is A union. This is the symbol for union. So this is it, union. Then the third one, intersection. Now what's intersection? Intersection is a common element between two given sets. Common element between two or more given sets. Now take for instance, is set A to be 1, 2, 3. Set B to be 2, 3, 4. So now say A intersection B. That's the symbol, intersection. We have one. What is common? This is common. This is common. It's about 2.3. That is intersection. So common element means intersection. Then the next one, number 4, is equal sets. Two or more given sets are equal to each other if they have the same elements. They are equal to each other if they have the same element. Now take for instance, set A to B, A, B, C, and set B to be what? 1, 2, 3. What do you notice about A and B? This one has three elements. Why this one also has three elements? So they have equal number of elements. Therefore, A is called what? B. Equality of set. We call it what? Equality of set. Number five. Single set. What's a single set? It is a one that contains only one element. The one that contains only one element. Now set A to B. So this is a single set. This is also a single set. So these are example of single set or singleton. Then the next one is what? Number 6. We have power of set. Now, the power of a set is the number of ways a given set can be written without repetition. Again, the power of a set is the number of ways a given set can be written without repetition, and it is represented as 2 raised to the n. So n represents number of elements in the set. Number of elements in the set, that is n number of elements in the word set. Take for instance, we have one now. Set A to B, 1, 2, 3. The question now says, what is the power of this set? What is the power of this set? So the power of the set is what? The power of this set can be written as the first one is what? 1, 2, 3. That's the first thing, that's 1. 1, that's the second one. 2,
That's third one. Three. That's the fourth one. 1.2. That's fifth one. 1.3. 2.3. And empty set. So let's count. How many times now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Don't forget, it must end with an empty set. It must end with an empty set. So that is it. Or you apply this formula, which is what? 2 raised to power. The number of elements is 1, 2, 3. 3, which is what? 8. 2 in 3 places, which is 2 times 2 times 2. That's 8. So we have 8 ways. That's what we explain. That is power of set. Number 7. Cardinality of set. What is cardinality of a set? That is the number of ways. Sorry. Cardinality is number of elements in a given set. Now, take for example, set P. Now, how many elements do you have here now? We have 4 now. P has what? 4 elements, which is what? It is 4 cardinal. So that is what called cardinality. Cardinality means number of elements in a given set. Then number 8. You have difference of sets. Difference of sets. Now, difference of sets is what? It is the sets. It's the number of elements in the first set which are not in the second set. How do I mean? If you have A minus B, you subtract B from A. So, it is different between the two sets. Take for example, you have then set B. So, A minus B now means what now? A minus B. So, which is element in A. So, if we subtract the common one, what are the elements remaining in A? So it is A minus B. Just for that small letter A. That is different between the next one is what? Symmetry difference. Symmetry difference. What symmetry difference? It is the union of the difference between the two sets. How? Which is what? A symmetry B. Because of what? A minus B union B minus A. This is the first way you can calculate it, or A symmetry B is equal to what? A union B minus B A intersection B. Aha. So these are the ways you can calculate A symmetry, symmetry difference. How? Now take for example, A is equal to what? A, B, C, D. B to be what? C, D. Now, want to solve the two questions that are under the symmetry difference. So A minus B means what? A minus B is that after you have cut, let's cut the common elements. So what are the elements remaining in A? Is what? A comma B. Then B minus A. So after we have cut, what are the elements remaining in B? The elements remaining in A here, don't forget, then B. E comma F. Then asymmetry B is the A minus B union B minus A, which is completion of this. E is what now? Level A B E F. That's the first way. The second way, Anita. So A union B. Let's find A union B. A union B means the union between A and B. Level A B C D E F. Then A intersection B. Intersection. So what are the common elements? C, D. Then you now subtract the two. Subtract it from this. Cut this. So you have one now. The last element remaining are A, B, E, F. So this second way to get more symmetry difference. Second way to get symmetry difference. Then the next one is what? We move toward complementary offset. Complementary offset. Complementary offset. That is of a set. Complementary of a set. What is not that set when? These are elements remaining in a universal which are not in the given set. E.g., if our universal to be 1, 2, then our A to be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Then what of A complement or A prime? How do you get that? So elements remaining in universal which are not in the given set. So this the set A. If you subtract from the master, what are the elements you bring in? It will remain 1. Then because these all are even numbers, remain 5, 7, 9. So these are the elements that will remain when you take away this from the universal. So this is A complement or A prime. A complement or A prime. The same thing applicable to B. It will also be B complement or B prime. Then subset. That is number next. Subset. When you say subset, subset A could be subset of B. If A is a smaller set and B is a larger set, then B contains all elements in A. Therefore, we say A is a what? Subset of B. A is a what? Subset of B. Aha. So which means A is smaller than B. If A is what? A, B, C. Then B is on the one now. A, B, C, D, E, F. Now, look at the two examples now. A is a subset of B. Or write it like this. B is a proper set of A. Aha. Like this. So, which means B is greater than A. So, B contains all elements in A. Are you seeing this? This one will swallow this and it will remain D, E, F. Check it. So, that is subset of. Then the next one we need to understand again is what now? Is non-set or void or empty set. When you say non-set or void set or empty set, this is the one that contains no elements. It is denoted as or empty set. The element now, example of this one is what? A man without head. Have you seen a man without head before? No, it's empty set. It's empty. Nothing there. So there's something so denote like this. But don't denote it like this. No, this one is wrong. No, that is wrong. Is it like this or like this? That is empty set. Could be written like this and like this. And these are the major terms we use. And major terms we use in set. If you, I know if you come across them, you'll be able to solve them very well. Now, let's just solve one example under this set. Now, the first one is what? If set A is equal to what now? 1, 2, 3, 4. And set B, 1, 2, 6, 8, 9. Then find the following. A complements, comma, B complement, comma, A union B complement, comma, A complement union B complement. Let's try this first. Now, according to what we have there, we have set A, set B. So universal will be given. So in question, universal 1 to 10 is our universal. Don't forget that your A and B will not be more than our universal. So A complement means what? When you subtract A from universal, what are the remaining elements inside universal which are not in A? If you cut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from universal, it will remain what now? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is A complement. Then B complement. Now, cut B from universal. If you cut 1, it will remain 2. If you cut 3, it will remain 4. If you cut 6, then it will remain 5 also. If you cut 6, it will remain 7. If you cut 8, it will remain 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If you cut 4, it will remain 10. Then the next one, we need to get A. Ordinary A, union, B complement. So what is our ordinary A? Our ordinary A is 1 to 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one is sort. Now, A union. So union between this and this. Union between this and this, which is what now? Without repetition. It will be what now? A union B complement. It will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10. That is A union. The union between this and this. Then the next one, A complement, do not be complement. This and this. So A complement will not be complement. So which is what now? 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That is A complement,
you know, B
complement. So these are the examples where you have to use the complementary of sets, solve questions involving sets, and these are the things you need to know about sets before you go to laws of sets like commutativity, associativity, distributivity, idempotence, De Morgan, all those laws. They can be proved also using Venn diagram. But these are the major aspects in set. You can also solve more on this by not relying on this. You can solve more on set and, you know, of set. So that's all. Thank you.